For more videos on people's struggles, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.
Hello and welcome to Around the World in 8 Minutes, a show from People's Dispatch. In this show, we bring you stories of resistance and defiance from across the world. As the collective strength of the people fights back against the horrors of capitalism and imperialism and strives for a better world. We begin with a tribute to Comrade Abhimanyu, a young activist of the left-wing Students' Federation of India and a student of Maharaja's College in Kerala, who was martyred on July 2, 2018. Abhimanyu, who came from a very humble background, was brutally murdered by criminal elements affiliated to the Islamist fundamentalist organization, the Popular Front of India, and its student wing, the Campus Front of India. Throughout his life, Abhimanyu had been an inspiration to his friends and comrades, and resolutely held high the flag of radical politics. In his memory, the Students' Federation of India organized rallies across the country, where his comrades swore to uphold the politics and values Abhimanyu lived, struggled, and died for. We next go to Libya, where on July 2nd, over 50 people were killed in an air raid, targeting a refugee detention center near the capital Tripoli. The attack also left around 80 people wounded. The internationally recognized Government of National Accord blamed the Libyan National Army, or the LNA, led by General Khalifa Haftar for the attack. However, the LNA has denied any responsibility and has blamed the government forces instead. The LNA said that the government forces carried out this attack in response to its offensive against one of the military camps in the area. The Libyan National Army's attempt to capture the capital city Tripoli began in April this year. Forces loyal to the internationally recognized Government of National Accord have been resisting this offensive. Last week, the LNA lost an important town, Garyan, to the forces of the government. This led to LNA commander Mohammed Al-Manfur declaring their intent to escalate airstrikes in order to liberate Tripoli. LNA also blamed Turkey for providing support to the Government of National Accord. The detention camps for African refugees and migrants leaving for Europe through the Mediterranean Sea is located near a group of military camps belonging to forces loyal to the government. Libyan coast guards capture these refugees and migrants and keep them in these detention centers, often in inhumane conditions. According to the UN mission in Libya, there are more than 3,500 such refugees and migrants locked in these detention centers in the country. However, other sources claim that the number is as high as 20,000. The real number of refugees and migrants from other parts of the Africa is almost 800,000. Since these detention centers are surrounded by military camps, they are under the constant threat of coming under crossfire while between the warring factions. While the allegations fly thick, what is undoubted is that this is a war crime of utmost gruesomeness. The intervention of Western countries in the politics of Libya marked the beginning of a disaster that continues to this day. As rival forces fight each other, it is millions of Libyan people who are suffering in the crossfire. They are damned if they stay in the country, and they are damned if they try to escape it. We move on to another story involving migrants and the way countries of the world assault their humanity on a day-to-day basis. US activist Scott Warren, against whom legal proceedings were dropped recently on charges of aiding migrants, is all set to be tried again. The case against Warren, who is an activist with the organization No More Deaths, was declared a mistrial on June 11th after the jury could not arrive at a unanimous verdict. However, on Tuesday, it was announced that he would be tried once again on charges of aiding the migrants. Warren was arrested in January 2018, along with two migrants from a structure known as the Barn in Tucson, Arizona. The Barn is a staging point from where No More Deaths operates by providing water and other aid supplies for migrants who crossed the hostile desert at the Mexican border. Warren and No More Deaths have maintained throughout the process that the two were allowed to rest and recuperate, having suffered severe dehydration and heat stroke in the desert, where temperatures go up to as high as 50 degrees Celsius. They have also alleged that the arrests in January 2018 were a vindictive act by the Border Patrol officers, as it happened within hours of No More Deaths posting a video that caught the officers destroying bottles with gallons of water left in it. The prosecution, led by US Federal Attorney Nate Walters, tried to claim that Scott Warren was conspiring to transport and harbor the two migrants. As evidence, they presented his call records, which included his communication with a Mexico-based aid activist. Warren rubbished the accusation and clarified that the calls were made to coordinate the logistics of their aid work and nothing more. In the latest trial, the conspiracy charge has been dropped, but Warren will now be tried on two charges of harboring an undocumented migrant. Experts say that this case is of vital importance as it will set the precedent on the so-called limits of humanitarian activity. Clearly, according to the authorities of the United States, aiding those whose lives are at risk and who have endured unspeakable horrors to escape conflict zones is a reason for prosecution, as opposed to a basic human duty. We next head to South Korea, where tens and thousands of irregular workers employed in state-run enterprises protested on July 4th as part of a countrywide strike. A large number of protesters from a variety of sectors gathered at Seoul and shouted slogans against the government. Irregular workers include those whose positions are not permanent and those who are paid by the hour. They are paid far less and do not get many of the benefits that their permanently employed counterparts get. Many of them also work in dangerous conditions. The protesters demanded that the government look into their status and provide them permanent employment. We end with a protest in support of whistleblower and WikiLeaks founder Julian Assange, who turned 48 years old yesterday.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Julian. Happy birthday to you.
Assange is in Belmarsh prison, facing a multitude of charges. His crime is exposing wartime atrocities by the US in Iraq, Afghanistan, and other war zones. Much of what Assange has published has become part of the mainstream narrative today. On many other issues, the documents WikiLeaks published are the only credible source of information. Yet, there are many in the media who would deny that he's a journalist and seek to shut him away for a lifetime. The fight for the liberty of Assange is a fight for upholding the values of journalism itself. Across the world, such protests have been happening, a sign of hope, as Assange prepares to take on the might of the United States. That's all we have time for today. To read more about these stories, visit our website, peoplesdispatch.org, and follow us on Facebook, YouTube, and Instagram. Thanks for watching.